Hello, Merry Christmas. This is the Phantom Safety Pin, and this is the last video of the 2010 LP Advent Calendar. Well, the last video outside of the extras, but this is the final LP. This is a game called Drop Dead, and this is actually the extended edition, and there's not much to it, really. It's really just a game where you go, and you drop this thing, Beetle Bear! And the idea is to see just how bloody a death you can give Pedo Bear. I love this game. It is such a good anger management tool. And, think of what you're supposed to do is see just how bloody a death you can give, this Pedo Bear lookalike. And it's a lot of fun. It's such a good anger management tool. Why'd I pick this one last? Because, also you can reset the game by hitting R. I'm sorry, this is the most awesome anger management tool ever. It'll slow down when his head pops off, by the way. Or such. In the third extended edition, yes, there are three editions of it. Like, in the third extended edition or so, you can get, like his bones show up. You're gonna see me, scrolling down a lot so you can see what happens to Pedo Bear here, but, you're gonna see me replaying it a lot, see if I can get bloodier deaths for you guys. But the whole idea is that it's a dolly torture center. And all you do is throw the doll, see where he lands. Throw the doll, see where he lands. Excellent! Oh, he missed the one thing. Let me reset this a little bit for you. Oops. Bad shot there. Drop. Now watch when this thing hits him. I love this game. This is the best game for creating pedophiles. Like, not pedophiles. This is the best game for creating freaking psychopaths ever. It is the bloodiest game. It's just generally all about destroying the doll as much as possible. So I'm gonna shift through all the different scenarios here. And sometimes the scenarios will differ each time, like you'll have different combinations of saws and gears and wheels and stuff. Like here he got stuck. And there goes his torso. You can also, H brings up the help menu. You can change the character if you want, or you're gonna stick with Pedo Bear. You can change the blood color, you can toggle the music, sound effects, and such. And, that's it. Look at the head! Look at the head! Oh my god! So why did I choose this for Christmas? I don't know, your guess is as good as mine. Probably because we all know I'm a complete psycho at heart. That's about everybody is. It is such a good anger management tool. Oh, to the crotch! Did you see that? Ouch. Yeah, I can change the blood. Oh no, that changes the character. I'm sorry. My bad. But yeah, you can change the blood. See, here's all the different colors of blood. I'm gonna keep it on red because I like red blood. Yeah. In the third game, ooh, this is my favorite scenario. But in the third game, you can actually get him to show bones. He turns into bones. Look at that hand. And There's also more characters in third, and also an option to make your own level. That is why this is my favorite scenario of this game. But yeah, as you can see, they change every single time. This game is one of the most entertaining games to watch ever. And the more carnage you cause, eventually the more points you get for it. He's stuck. But yeah, as you can see, we change our arrangement for the saw every so often. Why is my mouse not moving? We change the arrangement so often, every so often. But this wasn't a very good arrangement. This is... It's not always the same number of saws either. It differs every time. He's stuck. Why is this game so fascinating? What is wrong with me? Yes! Yes! I just fed him through it! The saws actually stopped because he got stuck. Look at his head! Look at his head! Look at his head, look at his head, look at his head. Oh my god. Okay, that's enough of this scenario. Now, this game is actually so big, I cannot show the whole screen at once. There's another saw down here. And it's so satisfying to watch. This is actually the kind of games I used to play with my Barbie dolls and shit. When I was a kid, I would like freaking throw them at shit and then just see just how long it took them to fall apart, shit like that. I was a weird child. These pushers are like jack-in-the-box mechanisms. And they're hilarious. Oh, there's not more at the bottom, oh well. But there's actually several different versions of Drop Dead. I don't know why there's so many versions. Particularly when, this game is basically all just about destroying things. There's nothing down here. Oops. Too far up. There's nothing down there, just... floor. So the idea is to see how much you can make them hurt with this floor. This was from the original Drop Dead. Whoa! Let's see if it'll hit it. Ooh, yeah! Awesome! Did you see that? Let's see if we can redo that. See if we can get a little more out of it. Oh my god! That is so violent! Oh! Ouch! The humanity. That's what you freaking get, Pedo Bear. He's trying to hold on to the rope so bad. Oh! Yes, I love this game. Is it so hard to tell? You don't even have to move him very far. He'll usually fall by himself. He didn't quite fall apart this time. I'm trying to see if I can get him to completely fall apart. God, this game is so ultra-violent. This is not a kid's game, guys. If you have kids, don't let them play this game. Oh, he pretty much already fell apart. I'm sorry. There's also, like, some bombs and shit in the next game if you... Yeah, his head came off already. This is like the Joker's freaking play box. This is what he does to his victims when he gets bored. Fun box! Yeah! And now, Batman, you will go to the fun box! The fun box? The fun box! Awesome. And now it's all. I love this game. It's okay. We all have a bit of a sociopath in all of us. I love those bouncer thingies. I don't know what they're called. I just call them the jack-in-the-box pieces. Keto Bear is getting absolutely mangled. Holy crap. Oh god. Oh my god. I don't know, this game is so much fun. Mangle. Yeah, if you send him down, it'll mangle him. Pretty effectively. Oops. See how far I can get him to go. Wah! Oh, that's not what I want at all. There we go, that's more accurate. For he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow. This is the world's best anger management tool ever. And actually, this is exactly, guys, what I used to do to my dolls. Awesome, I got him to lay across the saws. So then carry him down here. Which means hopefully by eventually by the time he gets down here, he'll be all in parts. Confetti! Look at it! Look! Oh god, this game is so hilarious. Or I could just stick him on there. Christopher Robin, if you only knew what those horrible people were doing to your toys. Did you know Christopher Robin is actually the name of A.A. Milne's son? Whee! That's awesome. By the way, this is the same guy who did the Perfect Balance series. He's the same guy who made this game. Why? Because haven't we all pretty much destroyed our toys as kids and pretended they bled to death? Hello, anybody? Please tell me I'm normal. Or we had, or at least we had an uncle who did. This head already popped off, oh my god. Freaking, Keto Bear has like no energy or health whatsoever. That's what happens if you spend all your time chasing pupubescent children. There's so many ways you can mangle the shit out of this character. His head already popped off. Whee! But you might notice some of the sounds from Perfect Balance, Playground, or various other games that the same guy has done. He got stuck. God, I love this game. Now that you all know I'm a complete psychopath. Oops. Ha ha ha. see if I can get him to fall. Directly down across the saws. Welcome to my torture machine. Good. Beetle Bear just has no freaking... This is what hell is like for Beetle Bear. Children throwing against countless contraptions. Preferably demon children. Again, come on. You can't tell me we didn't all do this kind of thing as children. Play with our dolls, rip them to fucking pieces. Like, as you can see, yeah, see, the arrangement of the, pushers change it every time. Doesn't know about the bear is pretty much made of porcelain. Gonna get a better one. There we go. Well, then what more can you say about a game that wants you to mangle a bear? What more can you say about a game that wants you to mangle Keto Bear? Yeah, that's what I wanted to do. As you can see, this guy did it in his spare time. So what do you think that says about this guy? The man has a lot of problems. If you're lucky to carry, oh no. His head got completely stuck. But yeah, in this particular game, there's a lot of times you can accidentally get Peter Bear's head stuck. So you dropped it too. Why is there a dead pig head there? I have no idea. Because there is. Woo! Did you see that? He exploded into like pieces immediately. Some distance, holy crap. And there's actually, I think this is back to scenario one. That's the end of all the scenarios. So that's the end of Drop Dead Extended Edition. So until next time, this is the Phantom Safety Pin. Peter Bear is going to continue living in hell. And hope you guys have a Merry Christmas. Hope it's not as gory as this. And until next time, this is the Phantom Safety Pin. This was Drop Dead. This was the 2010 LP Advent Calendar. If you guys have suggestions, put them in the comment section below. I'll try to get to them for next year. No promises, but I'll try. Until next time, I will see you later. I will see you later. Goodbye, Merry Christmas, and Happy Holidays.
Have a holly jolly Christmas. It's the best time of the year. I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and when you walk down the street, say hello to friends you know and everyone you meet. Ho, ho, the mistletoe hung where you can see. Somebody waits for you, kiss her once for me. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and in case you didn't hear, oh by golly, have a holly jolly Christmas.